Hello, Sinvicta.
Hello, Northern Lion. Happy Friday.
Thank you. Thank you.
We're
happy Friday to you as well.
Geared up to record another session of GeoGuessr immediately following this episode.
Of course.
But let's see where this week ends. Now okay, tied 1-1. 1-1.
3-2-1. Good luck.
Good luck. Have fun. Diverse world. I've been getting a couple questions of people asking if we are going to go back to classic GeoGuessr eventually.
What are your thoughts on that?
It doesn't really bother. I mean, I'm for either one. I will say that not having a curated list is a little more appealing just because of the randomness factor in it all. It's a little bit more true to the GeoGuessr experience, I guess. But at the same time, it also is quite the benefit to not have to deal with Russia and Brazil every other guess.
That's pretty much where I'm at.
Yeah.
It's like, I don't want to go back just because we get, I mean, I think people have forgotten maybe if they want to see something that's not diverse world, like literally 40% of the guesses are Brazil and Russia.
Or somewhere in the boondocks of Australia.
Yeah.
Where there's just nothing around.
Which, like, don't get me wrong, if you live in Brazil or Russia, it's probably pretty sick. But
do you really want two Westerners fumbling around your country complaining about how bad the camera is or how there's like no flags everywhere?
Oh, the roads aren't very nice here. Oh.
It might be something to do like as a special week or something to go do a non-diverse world for
honestly though,
or two.
Like my perspective is if we're going to do something special, I would rather do more curated, like one-off seeds that are like, you know, soccer stadiums or like,
right,
you know,
right.
World landmarks. Cause like, I don't know, honestly,
yeah.
This playlist has revitalized GeoGuessr for me. I come across strongly in my opinions. Sometimes I apologize for not having a more measured response if people disagree with me, which is fine. But I'm like, the number one complaint I hear about a more diverse world is that sometimes it seems to not be that diverse because we get two of the same country in one scene.
Right, right.
But I'm also like, that happened all the time.
Yeah.
On regular GeoGuessr, except instead of maybe being like two Jordanian guesses, it's two Russian or Brazilian guesses every time.
Which, again, to make a point, is it's nothing against those countries, obviously. It's just...
No, they're just big.
They're huge. They're freaking huge.
And unlike... And America had a lot of guesses, too. And Canada got a decent amount. But Canada's large, but a lot of it is not, like, innervated with roads that get hit by Google Maps, I think.
Yeah,
you know, there's, like,
yeah.
huge swaths of the country that are essentially just, you know, brush and tundra.
Do you know where we are?
I'll tell you, I know the country.
100%.
I would say 100%, yes.
Yeah.
So would you? So legally, no. But I'm very, very close to. I would put myself at 95% certainty that I'm in the country.
I would be surprised. Well, I guess there's really like three countries that I could be going on. The thing is that this part of this name is bothering me because that would say that we're like down here somewhere. So maybe we're in here or here. I'm pretty sure it's not there.
I'm just going to put us down.
I'm going to say over here.
Well,
but closer to. Yes. I'm going to say closer to this part over here. I've got 3 seconds.
I was in that 5% range.
Yeah.
I put us down in Kyrgyzstan.
Kyrgyzstan.
Can I tell you one of nature's cruel jokes?
Yes.
You know that character that kind of looks like a butterfly?
Yes.
Turns out that's also in the Kyrgyzstani language. So what you might have expected is I would zoom in and be like, the character doesn't exist. It's not the case. Definitely does.
Well, I got you by 4,000.
That's a lot.
I went originally I was in the Ukraine and Belarus around there, but there was the thing that kept me on this side of the map was that there were English characters on the city name. Okay. And the city name said Tsar, like T-S-A-R. And I was like, that's got to be more towards like the Turkish region. And I'm pretty sure it's not Romanian. So I put us on the border of Romania and Belarus just in case, if it is around there.
It was just a comedy of errors for me then. Because I'm diagnosing it. And I'm like, what happened is like, you know, 3 months ago we had a Kyrgyzstan guest. And I was like, if I ever see mountains like that again, I'm going to pick Kyrgyzstan. And then I was like, yep. And then as soon as I saw the same character, I was like,
Kyrgyzstan. That must be
it. Yeah, that's Kyrgyzstan. I don't know where it is, but that's fine. It's a very tough mistake to wean yourself out of.
But
it's
an easy mistake that anyone can make.
That's what I mean. It's like, you know, like the first three pieces of information I saw seemed to confirm the hypothesis that I'd already accepted it.
We're in this city.
If by this city you mean Wellington, New Zealand,
where is the city? I mean, I've seen the. I know where we. I know. Look, I know where we are.
Is the city name what I am 95% likely to do once we see the scores?
Yes. That's the city that I'm going on, but I also saw it on a sign, I think.
Yeah, same.
I mean, it's not 100%, but yeah, it's quite a big margin.
Yeah.
Who cares?
It's literally not 100%. But
not 100%.
I mean, I don't even mean to lose. I mean, like, in the... like where we are.
Oh no, yeah. But I mean, I saw a movie, or it was like a national space exposition or expo or something. It said Toulouse on it, but I've never actually been to this part of France. So,
the south of France. Yo, they got Uber Eats.
Yeah.
Here.
Bulma, my favorite Dragon Ball Z character. I enjoyed France. It wasn't the most fun place to be as a kid, but it was always neat just to go across like the sea like that to like, oh wow, there's a big freaking continent over here.
You know, I did not know that you'd been to France.
What? Yeah, I've talked about it before. We went to Paris, Belgium, Brussels.
I know you went to Belgium.
Yeah.
I didn't know you went to France.
Yeah, we went to Paris mainly is where we're going. For a time, I thought we were planning on going to Marseille, but that fell apart. Of course,
How
I wasn't.
How old were you when you went to France?
I was seven or eight.
That's young, for sure.
I wasn't old enough to call the shots nor appreciate the finer things of adulthood.
That's what I was gonna say.
Going to a different country and stuff.
When I think of going to, like, France. A lot of the stuff that I would want to do there is kind of lost on a child. You know, I'd want to like eat weird cheeses and drink good wines.
Yeah, that's something that I'd love to go. I think I will go back to Europe at least one more time before I kick the bucket, because I think that
You're
would be
screwed,
cool.
You're screwed, brother. I got you by 4 points.
Oh man,
3,996 to go. Look, you got a long time left, even with a pessimistic outlook
and a non-vegetable eating diet.
You told me last week you're eating some vegetables, so
hey, I'm trying, man. I'm trying. Where in the world? This sounds like Are you looking at the Setha stores one?
Well, I saw the B word that you were about to say.
It looks like a Harry Potter spell. Boga Wanthaloa. Yep.
I'm just choosing to let that pass.
Maybe I'm drying here. Oh, well. The thing about these languages is that I'm surprised at how different they are, but I cannot for the life of me comprehend how someone could be bilingual in them.
Oh, yeah.
They're so different.
Yeah, I have no idea. I'm the wrong person to be talking to about bilingualism.
You see what may be Cambodian, and you also see what may be Thai.
I was thinking like...
BOGO Drivers Union.
Well, you know what? I'm not going to tell you what I was thinking. Because okay. I think I would prefer if we were far apart and you were wrong on this one.
Okay.
That would be ideal for me.
I have a cleaner sign now to see the name. Boga Maga Wan Talawa. Wan Talawa?
Honestly, I don't have a good answer for you on that one.
Was that a what?
But I do see it on every sign.
But I saw a top level domain over here. That is just a scratch on a bus. Got it. But you know, the more signs that I'm seeing, the more it's starting to look a little Hawaiian-ish. And there is a rule that I established earlier in this season.
Yeah. If you think it's Hawaii, you put it in Hawaii.
If it sounds Hawaiian and looks Hawaiian, but it ain't, it's this country.
Gotta...
Of course, that could also be wrong.
I'm trying to remember what country you said it was.
Do you know the country?
Yes.
Okay. So if I tell you the country, you won't get mad.
No one will get upset because I am also in the right country.
You know 100% you're in the right country.
Yes.
Okay. So that rule that I had was for Sri Lanka. Was that if it looks Hawaiian, but you know it's not Hawaii, Sri Lanka.
Which is obviously crazy because we're
not in Sri Lanka
right now.
This is Waikiki, man. I want to know where you found all these characters at.
By characters, do you mean the people?
I'm not talking about the people, all right? I also found a BOGO shoe palace that literally says Sri Lanka's number one footwear.
See, that's what I thought we were in Sri Lanka, and then I saw that, and I was like, I know we're in Sri Lanka, and I still could not find BOGO Wathan.
Dang it, my mouse is like double clicking. It moved me at the last second. I was almost on top of where yours was, and then I was just moving around the map looking for that city, and it clicked me on the eastern side. But we basically got the same score, so.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. Oh.
Oh yeah, there's BOGO Walla Walla.
It's in the middle of it's at the base of a mountain.
That's it. You mean the Sri Lankan guess?
Yeah, yeah. I mean it's like a glass houses thing, but how do you expect me to find your city? Try putting it at the base of three mountains, then get back to me.
Called tourism, sister. Look it up.
I don't know how much tourism
Sri Lanka gets
on Sri Lanka.
I bet it's quite a lot.
I bet Sri Lanka gets. I bet it gets regional tourism. I don't mean to insult it.
What about Donisfjord?
Donisfjord, I bet gets local tourism. Would be my guess.
Dionysfjord, or Don? How do you pronounce that part?
I'm gonna surprise you again.
You don't know?
I couldn't tell you.
You just don't know.
I know you say Don, fjord,
right? Fjord.
Fjord. Yeah.
In Breivik, button.
That one, I.
Breivik.
Yeah, I don't really know. I don't know.
Reykjavik. Something Scandinavian sounding.
Vic means southernmost tip.
Okay.
So you should apply that logic quickly as possible.
So you're going to the far north, I take it, then.
I have no idea where we are, actually. As far as I'm concerned, all of this country is the far north.
I wonder how far north it is, because there's a lot of green here.
Yeah. No, I'm with you. I mean, Norway is definitely, it's like northern enough that parts of the country, I would imagine, would not look like this even in the summertime.
We'll get look pretty glacial.
I imagine so.
As Canadians call them, glacial.
We say glacier for sure. And our country actually has some. That's a mic drop moment.
Texas,
America might have some glaciers.
Texas has the Houston Texans.
Yep. We don't have an NFL team.
Yeah, take that. Boom.
And in fact, you have two NFL teams.
We do. Dallas Cowboys and Houston Texans.
Mm-hmm. America's team and...
And little brother.
Well, that's... team that has received or had accomplished essentially nothing over the course of their entire tenure in the league.
Not entirely true. The Texans were one win away from the AFC Championship. I'm not a fan.
Oh, they almost came in the top four.
They almost came in fourth. All right. I'm not a fan of the Cowboys or the Texans. I hope it's one of those things where like I hope the Texans always win, just because my mom is a huge Texans fan and it makes her happy. But I don't have a horse in that race. No pun intended.
Yeah.
Well, we're in Norway and we're near some water. So, you know, that could be a lot of places.
I think you should go on the eastern side of the country personally.
I think that, you know, it's to the west. I'm going to say we're going to be on like this random little island here near Hasvik or Sternova. Put us like right there. Oh wow, that's ridiculously close to where we actually were.
Dude, we were so far north.
We were super north. We were, holy crap.
What's the second largest city in Norway? Bergen.
Oslo, Bergen, and then Kristen.
It was on the Jeopardy test, and I was like, I should know this, but I blanked.
How close are you from actually getting on Jeopardy?
The thing is, it's impossible to know.
Okay.
But if you do well on the test, you may get invited to an in-person audition. The way I understand it, if you don't royally screw up the in-person audition, you're kind of like put into the hopper of contestant selection.
Right.
It could take like a year and a half to be selected, but it's really like the online test is the great filter.
Well,
yeah,
this one was a little bit more, I guess, clear cut than.
Hey, we're almost in Boston.
Hey, I'm trying to Boston here.
Freaking Tom Brady. why does everybody hate Brad Marchand just because he's licking people all the time? I don't get it. I don't know. What's a Boston accent? I'm trying to. It's like
the
Departed,
car.
Right? Yeah.
Don't want to go
Tom
too
Brady.
Far in the car.
Everybody's jealous of us because it's only frozen 7 months of the year.
It's almost, the Bostonian accent is almost like Chicagoan mixed with stereotypical Italian.
Yeah. No, that's, I'm starting to get there.
Yeah.
Why would you go to PAX West in the Pacific Northwest in the summer when you could go to PAX East in February? One of the coldest cities in America. I don't understand it.
You're getting more and more sly there as it goes on. I like it.
We haven't won a national sports championship in almost 15 minutes.
Yeah, there you
I'm
go.
Dying here.
There you go. Yeah. That's what Bear sounds like when the Patriots don't get anywhere.
Have you ever been to Boston?
I have not. I've the furthest of the East Coast I've ever been was Baltimore.
I don't mean to. I'm sure there are a staggering number of good people who live in Boston, but it's such a culture shock for me. I will never go back unless there's a compelling reason, like there's an event that I am being sent to, like. Cause I don't feel welcome in the city.
Really?
I just remember, like, there's every time, like, people have this perception that Canadians are aggressively polite. In Vancouver, that's not the case. People are merely personable. Small town Canada, sure, they'll bend over backwards to get you whatever you want. Personability is fine, but like in Boston, we go into a restaurant and we'd be like, you know, can you fit a table for six? And they'd be like, I don't know.
Oh, won't like, you tell me?
It's just like, and then like we walked into one, and I'll admit we had 10 people, which is a lot. But I was like, can you guys fit 10? And they're like, we're not really sure, but if you wait around, maybe something will open up. And I was like, all right, I'm just going to go like walk across the street and like see if these guys have a table for 10. And
they just
went, okay. Like they with the same dismissive tone. I get it. It's not, I don't want you to beg to keep my business. I'm just trying to eat. But it's like, you know, okay, let us know. You know, just like a little sunshine in the voice goes a long way.
Do you think, would you consider Boston ruder than New York?
Yes, absolutely.
Because I think most people stereotypically would think it's the opposite.
I think that it's, I don't necessarily think Bostonians are mean. I think maybe just culturally speaking, they're kind of cold to strangers or in like service positions or whatever. But it's a big culture shock for me.
I mean, really, you just have to go on how Mathis Games acts. And
Mathis is probably the nicest person from Boston I've ever met in my entire life. Everybody else is like, if you the first person to say please loses.
I mean, I'm friends with a couple of Bostonians. Tempo is a good friend of mine. He lives in Boston, and he's not like that at all. So
I'm glad to hear.
I know two people. Oh, fun fact: Tempo is actually Kofi Kingston's younger brother.
No, I did not know that.
Yep.
Fun fact: I'm from a town called Kingston.
Well, there you go. I put my guess down like 4 minutes ago.
Oh yes. Today.
I was just looking around in Bermuda and stuff.
24,324. Pretty good.
I will take it. I think I got lucked out on the Kyrgyzstan logic.
Even
of
with
Northern
that,
Lion.
I think you beat me. I mean, you crushed me on the Norway guess too. So it was really like
that one was pure luck. That was that was me going off of what you were talking about, and I said, oh, I'm going to go far north.
Some irony in that.
Yeah. Yeah,
because I didn't even know it was there.
I thought you like found it on the map, and I was like, "All right, well, this guy is telling me to go far south, so I'm going to do the opposite." I'll take it though. My first winning week in a while.
If I ever find the place on the map, tell Sinvicta exactly where it is.
You know what? That's probably actually the best thing you can do, because I'm going to immediately put Sinvicta logic there. And sabotage my game. But the Sri Lankan guess was
that was locked in.
Yeah, I mean it was a rule I established like a long time ago. So
yeah,
fun game either way. Good week except for Wednesday.
Yeah, good week except for Monday and Friday. For now, thanks for watching.
That's not what I meant by that, by the way.
You guys have enjoyed the episode. If you did, click the like button. No matter who you're watching, it helps out a great deal. Of course, subscribe if you want to see more in the future. For now, thanks for watching, and we will see you Monday.
See you later.
See ya.